when you're doing something as important as implanting a device in a patient's cerebrovasculature, you really have to be confident that it's going to get the job done and be safe and effective. We think about our classical aneurysm, such as the one in the Brain Aneurysm Foundation logo, a berry type that's round. The goal there is actually to make sure that the neck of that aneurysm is underlined by the stent. And then the stents, as they were initially intended when they were developed, was that the stent material itself is minimally porous. So it just has enough pores to slow down the flow inside the vessel, whereas there's just enough flow to keep tiny vessels open that may be supplying other important areas of the brain. You have to get that exactly right, or there won't be enough flow stagnation or slowing to close the aneurysm. If you have a wide-necked aneurysm deep inside the brain, it would be difficult, although admittedly not impossible, for a surgeon to access that and place the clip and convince coils to stay in something with a wide neck without falling out. If those coils do fall out, then they can cause a stroke. So the intention of the flow diverting stent was to address this particular situation. I essentially made it my personal mission, with the guidance of my mentors, to found cerebrovascular consortia who could answer that tough questions with high quality data collaboration. Around 2016, started to accrue quite a bit of good data on how efficacious flow diverters were. 8 years later, as an attending, many of those investigations that we undertook have answered many of the questions plaguing flow diversion. I think some of the things that have really become apparent for us in terms of when a flow diverter is most appropriate is wide-necked aneurysms, although we now understand that they need not necessarily be only of the internal carotid. We now have low-profile stents that can go more distal, what we call the circle of Willis. We can now go beyond that into farther, less charted territories. Aneurysms that are in the posterior circulation, meaning the back of the brain, or aneurysms that have funny shapes, we call them, you know, non-saccular morphologies, can often have no possibility of placing a surgical clip or fitting coils. These stents represent the only option, and fortunately, in many cases, an excellent option. Since the time when the Brain Aneurysm Foundation research grant was awarded, we've published over 100 papers. The most recent consortium that now has over 900 aneurysms in it, we have put out some of the largest bodies of evidence confirming performance of these flow diverting stents out of our own efforts. This can revolutionize clinical decision making and give patients with certain aneurysms that couldn't benefit from anything else a chance. And I honestly will never forget that when nobody knew who I was or what any of these consortia were, that the Brain Aneurysm Foundation was the first to give me a chance.